an event of December 2012.
It may
the
fall.
The new law comes in after March 2013.
Please don't
point.
Use dates as your
secondly,
argument.
She says nothing physical.
You hide behind you dates can, in your argument.
She's not saying nothing can physical happened.
She's
no
not saying nothing happened.
There can be and sexual harassment without even physicality.
Fine, but sexual there harassment various, is something. Even that,
there are various
I agree
levels.
With you.
So one man's friendly gesture can
no,
be taken
No. I think you're wrong there. No, Mr. Hegde. Mr. Hegde, you are wrong.
Touch relates to how the complainant's subjective perception.
No, no, one sec,
absolutely clear. Mr.
Hegde is going.
In the Vishakha
No, no, one second, one second. First of all, women of this country are smart enough to know the difference between a friendly gesture and something that is sexually offensive or sexual assault. And by the way, Mr. Hegde, go back and read Section 354A of the Indian Penal Code. You know, the whole definition of all the acts or behavior that constitute this particular charge will be clear to you. I have another question.
Yes, Mr. Goswami.
Yes, Mr. Hegde.
After March 2013.
Fine.
This is an incident of December 2012.
Mr. Hegde, now you're on.
Where you had the old unamended 354.
So you will now hide behind dates.
That legally, you would not, if you were to book a case now, you would not book him under this new law. Agreed, obviously, because the incident is earlier. But that is a legal point. My point is that the offence doesn't
Indira
change.
Jai Singh.
The offence and how it is
Indira Jai Singh yes. Coming back
and
to the debate.
Please give me an opportunity.
From Delhi, Indira Jai Singh comes back to the debate. Indira Jai Singh, please. Yes, please. Indira Jai Singh comes back to the debate.
Arnab. Yes, Arnab. Let me tell you, and in particular, let me tell Mr. Hegde that the law as it existed when this incident took place, Section 354 of the Indian Penal Code, outraging the modesty of a woman, applies with full force to Justice Ganguly. The punishment is 3 years. The period of limitation is 3 years. It is a cognizable offense, okay? So he cannot teach us what the new law is. We really don't want to know about what the new law is under the old. To Mr. Tulsi, I have this to say. Nobody knows Section 354 better than he does, for the simple reason that he defended KPS Gill against Rupan Vail Bajaj. And Rupan Vail Bajaj brought charges under 354 of the Indian Penal Code. And Mr. KPS Tulsi was convicted right up to the Supreme Court of India. Now, please hear me out, Arnab.
He'll respond to
I want to
that.
Tell you that Mr. Tulsi, please, Arnab, hear me. I want to tell you that in that case, Mr. KTS Tulsi, in a reported judgment, advanced the argument that the injury caused to the woman was so slight that no reasonable person would complain of it. And as you know, in that case, it was a slap on her bottom. This argument was rejected by the Supreme Court of India. So this is another tactic, okay? You're complaining. What are you complaining about? In that case, Rupan Vail Bajaj complained that he slapped her on her backside. In this case, we are told it was a friendly gesture. He put his arm around her. Whatever he did, I don't know. The report will reveal. But it's this attempt at trivializing, which I think needs to be condemned loudly and clearly if we want the women of our country to be respected.
You think you're...
If we want women to work in safe workplaces.
So you are saying that Mr. Tulsi is trivialized, right? And you are saying that Mr. Tulsi has taken a similar position while defending Rupan Deol versus KPS Gill in the previous case.
I have taken no such position in the present case because we are all groping in the dark.
Who's groping
we
in the dark?
We are not willing to wait for an FIR. We are not willing to wait for the report.
Has she said anything
wrong? We are just wanting to put pressure.
Has she said anything wrong? Has she said anything factually incorrect? Indira Jai Singh? If she has, tell her. If she has, tell her.
The word used in the complaint against Mr. KPS Gill was he has even hit me.
As far as she is concerned,
and the question really was that allegation did not have any sexual content.
Whether she means it in a legalistic sense that there was actual use of criminal force, or whether she means it in the sense of inappropriate touch, inappropriate conversation, we do not know the facts. We have to await the result of this inquiry committee, which I have no doubt will soon be public knowledge.
I totally agree with you.
The matter is coming up in the Supreme Court on Friday, And we should await what the Chief Justice of India does in that. We must trust the institution, if not the individual.
Now,
so therefore, Mr. Hegde, in February 2011. And the Chief Justice of India to come at a correct decision.
Mr. Hegde, 1 minute, please. You know, I first say this to you. Utmost regard for the Supreme Court of the country and the panel, which we are absolutely sure will ensure that with the facts at its disposal, the victim does not feel either aggrieved or painted into a corner, right? Or be made to feel like she did a wrong thing. That we have complete faith that the Supreme Court of India, especially the panel, will ensure justice. I want to ask you, Mr. Hegde, since you're being the most aggressive tonight on the other side. I you know, this is what Justice Verma said with regards to corruption allegations against Justice K.G. Balakrishnan's kin, who are accused by the Income Tax Department of possessing black money. He claimed Balakrishnan should quit as chairman of the National Human Rights Commission. I don't think you would say that the chairmanship of the West Bengal Human Rights Commission is in any way a position which is lesser or greater than that of the National Human Rights Commission. And this is what Justice Verma said. He says,
With great respect to the departed soul of Justice Verma.
You will not hear me?
I would disagree. I would respectfully disagree.
What did he say?
There are dangers which are much graver.
Mr. Hegde, Mr. Hegde, understand this. Mr. Hegde, a certain phrase.
A politician is asked to resign when a court frames charges against him, when it finds prima facie material.
A certain phrase.
Give judges or give people in tribunals the same kind of
certain,
protection.
Somebody may make an allegation. First of all, Mr. Hegde, you did not wait to allow me to read out what Justice Verma said, which I believe, despite your unbridled enthusiasm, is an incorrect thing to do. However, I would go ahead and read it. I would only like to say one thing most humbly, that the phrase illegal argument or illegal defense was a phrase which was used, I think, by KTS Tulsi. I don't think there is anything illegal in making the case like Kavita Krishnan says today, that the case
illegal
is that of propriety
pressure.
And morality. There's no illegality.
I said illegal pressure.
Illegal pressure is the word. So Justice Verma was
illegal
using illegal pressure.
Being, unconstitutional pressure being brought
was,
on
was the, was the respected late
it's
Justice...
It's an unconstitutional was pressure, the,
was the respected,
illegal.
Was the respected, very respected late Justice J.S. Verma, whose judgments will go into the history of the Supreme Court as one of the greatest men of integrity that the court has seen, was he also using illegal pressure? When he said the following, don't stop me, he said... You see, it's like this. Corruption is the most egregious form of human rights violation. And a person accused of serious human rights violation heading the National Human Rights Commission itself is a great travesty of justice. Was that illegal pressure being put by Justice Verma? Is what Indira Jaisingh is saying illegal? Is what Kavita Krishnan is asking illegal and immoral? Have we come down to a point where we cannot express our points of view? Is that what argument is this tonight?
Please give us the same latitude.
Justice
Verma is entitled to his drawing the line. We draw the line at what we think is a safer line to be drawn.
Okay, 5 minutes on the debate. Indira Jaisingh is responding to you.
Please give everybody due process, no matter what the allegation.
Point is taken. I take your point. Indira Jaisingh.
Arnab, I want to tell you that the judiciary does not need defenders like the two you have on your panel today. The judiciary is in a position to defend itself. And the judiciary has taken the right step by appointing a committee of three judges to look into the allegations.
Yeah.
It appears that the judges are taking these allegations more seriously than the two members of your panel are. So I would strongly recommend to them to leave the judiciary alone to defend itself. They don't need this kind of defense, okay? And what I do want to tell you is that we have a huge moral issue here. This is an institution, the Supreme Court of India, charged with the duty of protecting the rights of citizens. And if an allegation is made that those very citizens' own rights are being violated in what I would call the sanctum sanctorum of justice, I'm sorry, the standard is they must resign, they must clear their name if they have a name to clear, and then they can reclaim the office that they wish to be in. But so long as there is even the slightest suspicion against them, They must step down. And let me tell you, if he steps down, the nation will salute him for having done the right thing.
Mr. KTS Tulsi is still disagreeing with you. Questions will also be raised about whether the institutional integrity of the commission, which he holds, will also be compromised. Kavita Krishnan, you want to make your point? KTS Tulsi, with your permission, I let Kavita Krishnan respond, then I come back to you so you can respond to both of them together. Yes, no. Kavita Krishnan.
It's just a very brief intervention that I want to make about, not just about, you know, I think I've said what I want to say about the question of his stepping down, and I do stand by the fact that he should step down. I agree with all Ms. Jaisingh's arguments. I want to say something here, that what about any complainant in future? Imagine this woman's situation. Where are the safe places where such complaints can be made? All right. The Vishakha guidelines were passed in 1997. The Supreme Court has been insulated from them till now. Even now, the judges are out of its ambit. I would like to raise a question here. And you're having odious things being said, like women interns, will not be hired anymore, will not be taken on board anymore, etc. I think the question here is, for me also, that the law schools, you know, this woman was a student. I think, I would like to know, don't the law schools have Vishakha committees, functioning Vishakha committees, which could, had they been in place in the NUJS probably, they could have been a place where she could have taken complaint, and which could have actually looked into this matter back then. And similarly, the Supreme Court's present committee also, I think it can't continue to provide impunity to judges. It's just not acceptable. If you believe genuinely functioning impartial committee,
not providing,
then judges have to be in the ambit.
Not providing any immunity to the judges. In fact, I think it's looking at it fairly quickly and in a fairly detailed manner.
The present Vishakha committee.
Right.
The Supreme Court has just appointed a Vishakha committee. Ms. Jaisingh will correct me if I'm wrong, but I believe that it has kept judges out of its ambit. That's what I understand. Is that right?
Why?
The rules.
They have.
Why? Why?
Because impunity.
You're
asking me?
Do you agree with that?
I disagree. And I think, Arnab, let me tell you something here. Arnab, you need to know that this may not be an isolated case. And therefore, the question is, what systems are there in place?
Will anyone else have a chance to say anything?
No, you can respond after Indira Jaisingh. You're sure you will, Mr. Tulsi? I'll give you equal time to respond to her. Yes.
Arnab, this is not an isolated case. It may not be an isolated case. And the issue is there a system in place where people can take complaints they may have against judges? To whom? Where do we go with these complaints? It's a question which begs an answer. If we need to amend the Constitution, let's do it. If we need to put new laws in place, let's do it. Kavita has raised the right question, and it's a question without an answer.
Last response to the last word tonight to KTS Tulsi, who was smiling there as you were replying. KTS Tulsi.
You know, Arnab, I have great amount of personal regard for Indira Jaisingh, but it's just that on this issue we are pulled apart. And I very seriously believe that the solution that she is suggesting, that even before the FIR, even before the committee report, the Justice Ganguly, who has already been accused of a criminal offence, should step down. I say that we are going to, if this happens, we are going to lead to complete breakdown of the criminal justice system. We are going to begin with the presumption of guilt. We are going to compel people to speak up even when they have the constitutional right of silence. And this has consequences. Stepping down after you have been accused is only an admission of guilt, and that's not an option for anybody.
I think it is important.
We can't just say that nation will salute.
I think one solution
may salute, but you'll be in jail.
One solution is complete transparency of what the girl actually said before the particular committee, the details of what she alleged, and also the details of what she deposed before the judges, along with their points of view. If all of this is put out in the public domain, that transparency will not hurt anyone. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. We await the verdict. Thank you for joining me on debate number one on the News Hour tonight.